Rewiring the brain for peace is so important now because we see in the world around us a real thirst for meaning and connection, and more religious and spiritual approaches to the conflict and turbulence around us. And sometimes these religious and spiritual approaches can take a negative turn, but more often we're trying to prove that there is an antidote for the changes in the brain that occur through fear and violence, and that through ritual and contemplative practice, we can find new ways of connecting and making more positive meaning in the world.
And so for the last few years, contemplative studies, so the neuroscience of contemplative practice has made a lot of progress. There's been a lot of research around mindfulness meditation, yoga, for instance, with amazing results in the schools, or for PTSD, people struggling with PTSD, in particular veterans. But we want to expand two ways. One way is across the world, we know that since the humanity was born, actually, since we came to Earth, communities, individuals have used their resources, their spiritual resources, to transform fear, to resist violence, to create bonds together. And we want to tap into that and into all forms of practices around the world, really to expand what we are looking at. The other way we want to expand is to really connecting that inner peace and inner transformation with the outer transformation. And the way to do it is we're going to look at processes, emotional cognitive processes, and their connection with behaviors being transformed, relationship being transformed, and how they connect with peace building.
One of the most important contributions this project will make is in the realm of science. And as one of our neuroscientists said, we know more about subatomic particles and the surface of Mars than we do about the organ between our ears. And if we really are looking at approaches to violence and antidotes to fear, we have to understand the brain, the seat of emotion and compassion and all of the values that we bring to peace. So we'll be focusing on three different areas. First, a series of preliminary case studies to understand what a future research project might look like, to document field experiences, how societies are actually using these rituals and contemplative practices for peace, and then an interactive literature map that takes 900 articles that we've compiled and plots them on a map where you can really see these connections in a way that might not be expected. But just to emphasize, this is not only looking at the brain, but also embodied approaches. So how do our brains and our bodies connect in these spaces, and how do we measure those effects?
Yeah, and it's also in the brain, the body, and then environment. So really the interaction with the environment. So the type of tools we'll use and measurements are really going to embody that. And the way we want to this to be informative to people and to be useful, and that's also going to be a very important contribution of the project, is to translate that knowledge. So we are already developing tools from what we already learned from that interaction between the three fields, developing tools for individuals and communities to leverage their resources. So it's not to tell them, you have to do this to rewire your brain, but how can you really leverage what you are doing, your resources, into being more resilient, resist violence where you are, transform fear, reconnect differently together. So that's an important aspect. The other aspect is inspire and mobilize individual communities around the world. And we are going to work with fascinating, we are working with fascinating people, working with narratives and storytelling to really reach out to everyone who wants to be able to harness those resources and mobilize who we are as human beings and be better and build together a better world. That's hopefully our both modest and ambitious contribution, and we hope you will be part of that adventure with us.